Is edge computing the answer to tech sustainability? Mike Matera is the Director of Corporate Sustainability for Akamai Technologies. Thanks for being with me here today, Mike.
Thanks for having me, Karen.
Certainly. This is a loaded question, obviously could go many ways with this, but in a nutshell, is edge computing, is that the answer?
Yeah, I definitely think it is, right? Getting the content closer to the edge is super important. And not only helps with the environmental sustainability of it, but it also helps, I think, getting that content closer to the eyeballs. And what does that mean, right? Being able to cache content at the edge really saves and effectively helps the environmental sustainability of tech operations.
And for those that may or may not even understand, edge computing, because there's a large audience that does and many that don't, explain how it's going to help. I mean, when you say, reduction of carbon emissions, I mean, things like that, explain the benefits.
Yes, certainly. So with our deployed network of about 300,000 servers around the world and around 1,500 networks, we're able to cache content very close to the edge. And the benefits of us doing that, it enables us to really carry that traffic and really keep it at the edge. So when customers are looking for it, content, searchers are searching it out on the internet, we're able to keep it close to the people looking to access it, right? And having that content close, I think it really mitigates the overall impact of the carbon emission story. It really helps us eliminate waste, and also helps us get the content closer to the users, really helping us limit the overall carbon emissions exposure. And that's for a variety of reasons. One, because we work with our data center partners to obviously green up our operations, and two, we look for meaningful ways where we can do carbon offsets.
Yeah, and when you talk a little bit about too, in terms of benefits of, say, I would assume improved response times possibly, or even saving bandwidth. I mean, are those things that you all see a big difference in?
Certainly, yeah. Having the content close obviously really helps with the efficiency story. I think having that there and thinking about the power it takes to move content from one place to another. Having the efficiency there, I think really helps sing the narrative and the story of being able to kind of limit the overall exposure of what that content could potentially cause. Right? Think about power here at the end of the day. How much power it actually takes to power the internet. Having that content closer to the users not only helps on the efficiency side, but also helps limit the overall exposure to what we see with the greenhouse gas emissions, right? And if we're able to do it in an efficient way with our hardware and software, it limits the overall exposure of what that content is potentially causing.
All right, and so, and Mike, talk about with so many more IoT devices online. I mean, they're everywhere. Every business is using them in one way or another. How does that factor in?
Definitely, yeah. With the uptick of the devices, and I think over the pandemic, as an example, you're getting more and more requests hitting a lot of this content, right? So again, being able to cache content and keeping devices secure, again, that all has a power consideration at the end of the day. I think when a lot of people think about the edge and the cloud, they always think that it's being taken care of by somebody else. It's being supplied by somebody else, right? And there's always things where, as you see more and more people take on to the internet, we need to be considering that overall impact, right? So thinking of IoT, the thermostats, the cameras, the security systems coming online, right? That all has an impact in the content in which that those devices are receiving, whether that's communicating back to their home locations for updates, or communicating back to those areas for security systems, as an example, being able to make sure that police or somebody breaks in out of your house. Having all of those devices having a sustainable edge is critically important, because again, you're serving out content that has a carbon emissions impact, and being able to limit that obviously is of critical importance.
Most certainly. And how long, let me ask you, the Akamai technologies here, how long have you guys been in business, and what are the biggest changes you've seen just in the last couple of years?
So Akamai comes from a startup that happened at MIT. The company was actually formed in 1998. Our CEO is actually our founder, Tom Layton. Akamai was actually developed to solve the worldwide weight in a meaningful way. So having our kind of story and the narrative there, I think Akamai has really innovated over the years to figure out ways where we could power the internet to make it faster, more secure for folks trying to experience content all over the world, right? And our overall mission was to really build a company that was able to serve and help the internet become faster and a more usable place, right? And I think today, with all that underlying context, we've taken a really hard look at our overall impact, not only from a carbon emissions and environmental perspective, but how Akamai can kind of solve for some of these things, providing more efficient and more sustainable experiences at the edge. So I'm very proud to say over the past almost 22 years now, that Akamai has done an incredible job of being able to serve traffic and do it in a very secure, fast, and sustainable way.
All right, excellent. And before I let you go, talk a little bit too about machine learning, AI, that's all powering this. Talk a little bit about that.
Yes, certainly. So I think a lot of our software and hardware on the back end, folks don't necessarily think how it's being powered. And just thinking about the complexity about being able to actually understand and anticipate content that needs to be served at the edge, whether it's the latest video or the viral download or the next game, right? Having that on the back end and really being able to understand what content actually has to be there, I think is overall one of the most innovative pieces, right? Thinking of the algorithms, thinking of the technology, thinking of the software that's actually helping serve that content on the back end, and the innovation that it's taken to really roll that out. I think at the end of the day, there are a lot of component pieces here where the Akamai in intelligent edge with the machine learning and the AI and the software efficiencies and hardware are certainly something that have a true and meaningful impact in everyone's everyday life, right?
Excellent. All right, Mike. Again, Mike Matera with Akamai Technologies. Thanks for being with me here today.
Thank you, Karen.
Certainly. For much more, absolutely, on edge computing, what you need to know, make sure you check out Tech Republic. Thanks for watching.